At this point, you should have your API key for the New York Times. You're ready to start grabbing some headlines and the opening paragraphs to articles. Your code is going to be going inside the same loadData function as before. You'll be using the jQuery $.getJSON method to make this AJAX request. It's your job to write the code that makes the AJAX request. Once the data has been returned from the AJAX request, you'll need to parse it and then figure out how to present it on the page. The link in the instructor notes will take you to the GetJSON documentation on the jQuery website. I recommend checking out this first example to get an idea for what your code should do. Let's open up DevTools and inspect this page so you can get an idea of what your HTML should look like. Opening up the first article, we see that it contains an A tag to a link for the article, and it also contains a P tag with the text of the first paragraph inside. In the example, we're passing in a URL string of ajax/test.json. This could be any URL. And we also pass in an anonymous function. This anonymous function passed to getJSON will be run when the response returns from the server. Each article is in a list tag, and they all fall within an unsigned list with the ID of New York Times articles. I recommend starting off by console.logging the data that gets returned from this JSON request. You'll need to break it apart before you can start building articles. So, can you make an AJAX request to the New York Times API and get some articles about the city? You'll need to fire off the AJAX request, iterate through the response, and then present articles on the page inside the UL with an ID of New York Times articles. Check this box when you're done.